రైటికా సిఐ తెలంగాణ వార్షికోత్సవ సమావేశంలో కేటీఆర్ మాట్లాడుతున్నారు. ఇప్పుడు లైవ్ చూద్దాం.
రిజర్వ్ బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా, ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ జస్ట్ టు గివ్ పుట్ థింగ్స్ ఇన్ పర్స్పెక్టివ్, ఆర్ పాపులేషన్ ఇన్ ఇండియా యాజ్ అ స్టేట్ ఇస్ 2.5%, బట్ ఆర్ కాంట్రిబ్యూషన్ టు జీడీపీ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా ఇస్ 5%. సో దాట్ ఈస్ లిటరలీ తెలంగాణ పంచింగ్ అబౌవ్ ఇట్స్ వెయిట్, డబుల్ ద సైజ్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్. సో దాట్ గోస్ టు షో యూ వై ఐ కాల్ తెలంగాణ ద మోస్ట్ సక్సెస్ఫుల్ స్టార్ట్అప్ ఆఫ్ ఇండిపెండెంట్ ఇండియా. ఆర్ ఆనరబుల్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ is a firm believer, Shri KCR Garu is a firm believer in getting the basics right, in getting the fundamentals right. While, you know, it's easy to talk about emerging technologies, it's fanciful to talk about all the cool things that are happening all over the world, you know, the hyperloops and other things of the world. It's easy, I mean, it's all nice talk, but I think a country like India, which is still a developing nation, should get its basics sorted. So therefore, when we started our journey, we went with the 3I mantra: innovation, infrastructure, inclusive growth. That's exactly what we focused on in the last 7.5 years. Now, what do I mean by innovation? Innovation in today's world is often misconstrued as being, disruption in the technology area, startups, etc., etc. But innovation can happen on many, many fronts. You know, I was amused to hear Krishna when he said big companies cannot innovate. I beg to differ, Krishna. In fact, even big companies, in fact, can innovate, should innovate if they have to, they want to sustain, if they want to remain around. Because otherwise, you lose your edge, you basically lose your mojo, and you are gone in no time. Because if you think about it, 20 years back, Yahoo was a big name. Today not, and I think each of us in this room, or most of us in this room, the younger lot may not remember that, but most of us in this room had a Yahoo account. I did too. Now I don't even remember my password, because I don't use it anymore. It's lost its relevance, and now we have so many other things that have come up and so many other things that have just, eclipsed Yahoo and other behemoths of the early 2000s. That's the point I'm trying to make. Unless you reinvent yourself, unless you rediscover yourself, unless you reorient yourself to the changing times, changing demands, changing markets, any big company would not survive. The fact that GSK, the fact that, you know, all the big companies of the world still continue to be relevant in spite of the onslaught from Krishna Ella and his team means that they are doing something right. If not everything, they must be doing something right. The point I'm trying to make is invention, innovation is not confined to startups or technology alone. Even government should innovate. And that's exactly what we have done with our policy making. Mr. Bagla just spoke about how Telangana's industrial policies leagues ahead of anybody else. That is because our Honorable Chief Minister in this very room sat for 7 hours with the industry bodies, tried to understand in the very initial days of government. He said, let me sit with you, understand the pain points. Let me understand how I can make a difference. And in 2014, July, I think it was, there was a meeting held in this room. And by 2014, November, Telangana came out with its first legislation. That is the Telangana State Industrial Project Approval Self-Certification System, the TSIPAS. Now, it's like the easy pass, you know, that you would run into in the US. TSI pass has been extremely successful. And in case you're wondering, how do you say something successful? We have given out more than 18,000 clearances. We've been able to attract more than 2.3 lakh crores of investment. And we've been able to create a direct job potential of 1.6 million jobs. This is something that is truly amazing for a new state in India. And this growth, the numbers that I just reeled out, is all despite several things. It's despite the bifurcation blues, because the new state has to settle in. There are still issues to be tackled with the other state, with our brother state or sister state, as you would like to call it. We have still some issues to settle. The bifurcation blues are still, I mean, in some areas at least, they're still there. This is despite the fact that there was demonetization, which affected all of us, which affected the growth of states, districts, countries, I mean the entire country as such, industries also. And this despite the pandemic. 2 years of pandemic and still Telangana, in fact, as was pointed out by Mr. Bagla, if you look at an average, it's more than 13%. And if the same growth trajectory continues, then we would certainly be at that magical $470 billion or $500 billion, I think he was referring to. We'd be there by 2030, which is a humongous contribution to India's economy.